So firstly, a very good morning to you and to all my batchmates present here. I'm going to present my topic, that is endocrine regulation of molting in crustaceans. So before starting off the topic, I would like to make things clear that the regulation of molting in crustacean is still under process, like under study, and the whole presentation is based on different review papers and research papers, including certain Google leaks. So first is the introduction. So crustaceans are the large group of organisms which fall under the phylum Arthropoda, and vast majority of them lives in either freshwater or in marine water. So they have a particular complex physiology due to which multiple processes that may overlap each other. Those processes include molting. So molting is a cyclical process which involves the shedding of the exoskeleton through the rapid uptake of the water. And it's very essential for the crustacean for their growth, reproduction, and metamorphosis. So it is an interplay of the hormones which promote and those which negatively regulate the molting. And it undergoes four stages. These are intermolt, premolt, ichthyosis, and postmolt. Intermolt is the stage when muscle regeneration and accumulation of glycogen and lipid occurs. Premolt is the stage where the new exoskeleton starts in preparation. Ichthyosis is a period where which involves the shedding of the exoskeleton, and postmolt is a period when there is the expansion of the body due to the rapid uptake of the water. Next is the endocrine glands of the crustaceans. So first picture you can see is a schematic representation of the endocrine glands of a typical crustacean. I don't know my cursor is visible or not. So among the crustaceans, two endocrine glands are visible. These are the Y organ and the androgenic gland. So the Y organ is a pair of glands which is located in the thoracic region, and the secretion of the Y organ, that is the ichthyosteroids, is involved in the process of molting. Androgenic gland, on the other hand, secretes hormone that controls both the differentiation of the gonad of male into a testis, and absence of androgenic gland in the female results in the formation of an ovary that synthesizes hormone to promote the development of brood chamber and other structures associated with reproduction. Now the Y organ comprises of the neurosecretory apparatus, that is the eye-stalk containing sinus gland. So this is the enlarged portion of this particular area. So this neurosecretory eye-stalk is very important in the regulation of molting in crustaceans. It comprises of eye, sinus gland that stores the molting inhibiting hormone, X organ, neurosecretory fibers from the sinus gland, optic nerve. So this sinus gland contains most molting inhibiting hormone and also secretes other neurohormones and neurodepressing hormones which promote and negatively promote the regulation of molting. Next is the molting. So before knowing about the regulation of the molting procedure, we must know how the molting is done. So first picture is the structure of a typical crustacean cuticle. It comprises of epicuticle, exocuticle, principal layer, membranous layer, epidermis. Together is the endocuticle. This picture is the molting sequence in crustacean. The first is the intermolt stage. Here, the epidermis starts secreting the inactive forms of enzyme, which is also known as the molting enzymes, and due to which it detaches itself from the skeleton. After that, a new epicuticle starts secreting, starts secreting from the epidermis. The inactive enzymes, which is secreted by the epidermis, that is the molting enzymes, now starts dissolving the endocuticle portion. Here, the endocuticle portion. After that, this is the ichthyosis period. So the old epicuticle and exocuticle are discarded, like the animal pulls the self out. This is the post-ichthyosis period, where the new cuticle is stretched and unfolded and new endocuticle is secreted. So this is the entire molting procedure in the crustaceans. Now about the endocrine regulation of molting. So the molting is generally controlled by the eye-stalk X organ sinus gland complex, which secretes the molt inhibiting hormone, a neuropeptide that inhibits the ichthyosteroids production from the Y organ to stop the molting. Okay, so now we need to know the ichthyosteroids. So ichthyosteroids are the steroid hormones that regulate the molting procedure. The major forms of ichthyosteroids are ichthyosin, 20-hydroxyichthyosin, ponasterone A, 25-deoxyichthyosin, and 3-ethoxyichthyosin. When X organ releases mandibular organ inhibiting hormone from the mandibular organ. Now, this mandibular organ is located just near about the Y organ. It releases methylfarnioside. Now, methylfarnioside acts as a ligand and combines itself to the ignite steroids so that the molting is initiated. This is the one way. In another way, X organ sinus gland consists of MIH, which is stored in the sinus gland. MIH has an inhibitory effect in the molting procedure. Like it binds with the CGMP and CMP receptor of the Y organ so that the ignite steroid production is stopped. On the other hand, during the pre-molt stage, that is when the new exocuticle starts preparing itself, like from the epidermis it starts forming, at that time calcium ion increases, and due to which protein kinase and phosphodiesterase gets activated, due to which it stimulates actually the ignite steroids level and starts and initiates the molting procedure. So you can see that MIH, it is a molt inhibiting hormone, negatively regulates the ignite steroids production so that the molting is done. Another hormone, which is known as the crustacean hyperglycemic hormone, also has a similar activity like that of the MIH. It inhibits the molting procedure in response to certain environmental factors like pH, salinity, or temperature. It binds to the receptor of GC2 of Y organ membrane, which actually elevates the level of the CGMP, due to which the ignite steroids production is lowered and the molting is stopped. X organ sinus gland also releases VIH or GIH. VIH is the vitiligenous inhibiting hormone and GIH is gonad inhibiting hormone. They both have a similar structure like that of the MIH, that is in their cysteine residues. So it is thought to have an inhibitory effect on the Y organ so that the molting is stopped. Like it is thought to have, it is not surely known, but it's just thought to have. So events causing molting. So it is a general flow diagram of the events, how the molting is initiated. It requires both internal and the external stimulus. So when both internal and external stimulus are there, it triggers the central nervous system, that is the X organ. Now when the X organ is triggered, it stops the production of MIH. MIH is molt inhibiting hormone, so that the MIH concentration in the blood gets dropped. As soon as the MIH blood concentration in the blood drops, Y organ gets the chance to produce the ignition, and ultimately the molting is initiated. So here I like to conclude that molting is a very complex process which is affected by both external and internal factors. Also, hormones play a very important role during the entire molting process. So since some of the crabs or crustaceans are economically important, so increase in their molting activity, production can also be increased. Also, I like to say that crustacean endocrinology is still under study and it should be more focused at a molecular level. So these are the references from where I got my abstract, and thank you, sir.